Hey guys, what's up? I'm Matt, and in this video we're gonna fix your WordPress website not sending out any emails. We're starting right now. Log into your WordPress website. If you're still logging in using WP admin, not a very safe way, so please watch my tutorial about WordPress security because you don't want to get hacked. And the very first thing we need to check in here is you go to settings and you go to general. Now make sure to check that this domain name is your actual domain name. Because if you go to this domain, you can see that this is wpressdoc.com and this is wpressdoctor.com. This will not work. If you have your Gmail over here and not your domain name, put your domain name in here. So I should do like this. d@wpressdoc.com. That should work. Now, when you change this email address, you need to verify it first. Once you have verified it, come back and let's go to plugins and we're gonna add new. Now in here, we go to search for FluentSMTP. It's this pink one. FluentSMTP states on their website that FluentSMTP is free and will always be free. Yes, no pro version of license is required. And you can even connect it with Gmail, with Microsoft, with Amazon, and it's all free. And that's, my friends, why I recommend FluentSMTP over any other SMTP plugin out there. I personally used WP Mail SMTP for a long time, but it's expensive. I pay $100 each year to get it running with my Microsoft 365 integration. But then I found this guy, FluentSMTP. Press install now, and we're gonna press activate. And we press this big button, configure FluentSMTP. You can see that we can configure all of our email service providers with this plugin, and it's all completely free. Now that's really interesting. If you just want to send out emails from your own domain name and it's not working, we can choose other SMTP over here. This is what we do. We go over there, we scroll down, we're going to connect this website with your custom domain name over here. In my case, wpressdoctor.com. First, we're gonna specify our from name. So it's gonna be Matt. Then we're gonna put in our SMTP host. Now you want to have this information from your hosting company. This website is hosted on SiteGround. If you have a budget, it's a real good hosting company. If you're on a cheap site, go to wp.discount. Here you can find all kinds of hosting companies with discounts. What we need to do is use our SMTP over there. In our case, it is this SMTP outgoing server. So I'm gonna copy this. And then I'm gonna paste it in over there. And then paste in the port. Then make sure to use this port and paste it in over there. Now the encryption we need to do is SSL because it's port 465. And you might want to change it to TLS and then you have to use this port. But in our case, it's SSL. Use auto TLS. By default, it would be used if the server supports it. We'll see about this server. I don't know exactly. So just keep this on. Then we have to use authentication. Then we're going to fill in our SMTP username. In our case, it's just our email address over there. And then we need to fill in our password. Fill it all in and then you press save connection settings. Then we have an active email connection, an SMTP server with your own domain name from your hosting company. Then we go to email test over there. We're going to send it from wpressdoctor.com. And you want to send it to some other domain like Gmail, Hotmail, or Office 365, whatever. Put the HTML on and press send test mail. Test email has been successfully sent. That's great. Let's go to your Gmail to see if it really works. And then when I go to my email, I can see from Matt wpressdoctor, congrats, test email was sent successfully. So this actually works really great. This will make sure that every email sent out from my WordPress installation goes through this SMTP server. If you want to see it, you go to email logs. And in here, you can see all the emails sent from your website via FluentSMTP. Now, this is the test mail, as you can see it, and it was a success over there. It's green and it says resend, so that's great. If you send other mails from your contact forms, they will all appear here in your email log. So that works excellent. If you want to have another email connection, just click over here at another connection. If you want to use one of the other ones, just click on it. For example, if you want to have Office 365, then use this one. Make sure to check the documentation to create API keys at Microsoft because it's a bit of a hassle, but it will still work. Go to your website, fill out your contact form and see if everything works properly. If you have any questions or just want to say thank you, Matt, drop them down in the comments. I'll always reply. Hit that like button if I helped you out. And of course, subscribe over there because I got way more viewers than subscribers. And after that, check out this video and I'll promise they won't send you any emails. No emails at all, I think.